Oh, hey y'all. How's it going? Fatty here, and thanks for joining me on the channel that is as confident in its upload schedule as the weekend is navigating the Super Bowl. And today I am bringing you the guide on how to get a slot cap full of Flint. This is going to be for people who are just beginning out and are like Bobs, all the way up to endgame people who just want a really fast and convenient way to get Flint. And let's not waste any more of your time and just jump straight into it. So for this guide, it's going to be really nice. You're not going to need a transmitter, anything crazy like that. This is going to be all based on using natural spawn points on the map, as well as using drops to get in and out. So it's just going to be really nice. So if you want, the three things that you're really going to need is just like a bed. You're going to need some kind of flyer mount just to get out there, and it makes it really easier. And then sometimes if you want to get to a further drop or just go somewhere else, you know, it's nice to have that, as well as some kind of Flint farming dinosaur, whether that's going to be, you know, an Anki, or my personal favorite would be the Mantis. Those are really nice, especially since you can breed them now and get like super Mantis. But yeah, so those are the things that you're going to need. So definitely make sure you have those before you head out this way. You're also going to be in the desert in Ragnarok, where you're going to be a little bit dizzy if you get the heat stroke and stuff. So anything that's going to help out with that, you know, maybe a Kalan soup or anything that can just prevent that, med brews. Also having the bed out there is going to be good for two folds. One, when you see on the screen, you can actually spawn in on that location. I'm not. I'm going to spawn in on Highlands East. And show you guys the way I want you guys to be able to do this if you guys haven't been there before. But the benefit of having a bed is if you're off server, you can always spawn in on that bed. And then if you get heatstroke too bad, you can always find a way to off yourself a little bit. That way you can just respawn at that bed and not have to deal with the heatstroke craziness. Because even with ionize, that's oftentimes still there. And that is not what you want. So what you want to do is spawn on a Ragnarok map. And then when you do, again, spawn Highlands East. From there, you're going to want to travel to about 80, 55-ish on the map is going to be the location. When you're flying out there, you're gonna see this like giant crack and nothing else out there. That crack is gonna be your oasis. Everywhere through in there is gonna have so many Flint areas where you can get stone, sand, but mainly the Flint, and that's what you're gonna care about. And with a Mantis, you know, you're gonna be flying through there with how quick it hits. Just a couple things you want to know about. There are so many drops around here. On this little flyby, I'm going to show you a couple, but on the screen right about now, I'm going to show you the different drop locations all around you. So you can always screenshot this real quick if you guys are going out there so you know where these drops are going to be falling. But most of all, they're really, really close to this crack, so if they are going to be dropping, you're going to see it, so you can always just head to the closest one. And again, if you have a flyer, then you don't even have to worry about that. But if you are going to be out here on a Mantis instead of an Anki, a couple things you just really want to think about is that if you hit any of the Arthropleura out here with your middle pick, it's going to break it really, really fast. So bring a sword sometimes, or if you're going to fight the Mantis, or not the Mantis, the Arthropleura with your Mantis, just dequip your pick so it doesn't break, and it's going to save you a lot of trouble. Also, if you guys haven't made it this far, thank you guys so much. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I also have a PvP series that's been going like 18, almost 20 episodes strong now, so definitely go check that out. And if you guys haven't, I have a lot of other tutorials as well, so please go check those ones out as well. So when you clear all the ones on the inner part, what I would call like the under these rocks in this lower area, oftentimes you'll be pretty close to a slot cap. If not, if you just kind of go to the above ridges, you're going to find a ton up there as well. And there's easy ways to get slot cap. Even on a boosted server where, it, you know, you can have 5,000 like me on a single stack, I was still able to slot cap out here. So it is just really, really insane. If you guys need any guides, how to or tutorials on how to tame a Mantis, leave a comment down below. Let me know. And I can also get a guide out that for, you know, beginner players if you guys don't know how to get a Mantis and get those going. An Anki does work as well. You're just a lot slower. It just doesn't hit quite as fast, and it's a lot harder if you're doing this solo. Now, if you aren't going to be going solo and you have somebody else, you know, an RG and the Anki method is not as bad because, you know, you're just flying around. The Anki or the RG makes the whole situation just a lot faster, so you can always do that. But I would recommend getting a Mantis. It is definitely worth your time, and it's not that hard to get one on Ragnarok as well. But like I said, if you guys need a guide or a tutorial on how to get one of those, please let me know down in the comments below. And if not, I will see you guys in the next tutorial or PvP video. Peace.